भगवान श्री योगी राम सूरत कुमार की जय। सर्वं योगी राम सूरत कुमार अर्पणमस्तु। With deep gratitude, we have offered the Nama lotuses at the lotus feet of Bhagwan. This is no small grace that He has made it possible for all of us to do His Nama Sankirtan in this auspicious time of Sandhya Kal. And any attempt at any thought towards God will bear enormous fruit. Such is the power of auspicious time. Let us celebrate this grace which has made it possible for us. And as we say in the mornings, one more day is already gone and the new day, almost half of it is gone. And it's up to us to try and spend the rest of the day filled up with Nama. We all know that Nama and Nami are one and the same. Now yesterday, Shri Nochu Swami was here, and so he gave the message, the deeper message. I came across a sloka. Somebody had sent a video of Paramacharya where he recites this particular sloka, which is to be pronounced on the Deepam day. This is the third day of the Deepam celebration, and we can still see the Deepam on the summit of the mountain. Now the sloka says that even the worms, the insects, the birds, the trees, the kingdom of the plants, and all types of beings in the cosmos, we have to pray for their liberation at whatever level of consciousness they are. Paramacharya says that no prayer is complete without the prayer for the peace of the whole world. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. But then he said, this is one prayer that is made on the Deepam day, which is very special and different from the rest. What is it? I believe the ancient rishis would light the Deepam on the special day of Deepam, offer it to Lord Parameshwara, Lord Shiva, and also the Vaishnava god Damodar, and pray that even the worms, the birth of a worm, when a papatma, when a man commits a lot of crimes, sins, the next birth may be a relegation. It may be a lower level, a lowly animal birth, lowly plant, and it will take quite some time for him to come out of this janmas, the lower cadre, before he works out all these sins, the karmapala. Say a worm, an insect, even mosquitoes, they're also included, especially in the prayer, in the sloka. At whatever level of being it is, there are 84 lakhs of varieties of lives, beings. The whole cosmos, every one of them, the ancient rishis would pray for the Lord to descend into the flame, the sacred flame, and offer their tapas to the flame, to the Lord, and pray that every insect, worm, plant, birds, and every variety of being should be liberated from the cycle of births and deaths, that there should be no new janma, new birth for them. What a blessing, how generous of them, that they would offer all their tapas for the sake of all the beings, all the varieties of beings in the world, for their liberation. Paramacharya says, this Deepam day is one day we have to utter this particular sloka and make this particular prayer to the sacred flame where the Lord has descended to grant our prayer. It's a wonderful sloka. We did not go into the Sanskrit version of it. Enough to know the meaning. And the teaching is that no prayer is complete without our prayer for the peace of the world, the peace of the whole cosmos, for the peace and happiness. So, today is only the third day. We too shall offer this prayer at the feet of our Bhagwan, Yogi Ram Sarat Kumar, who is none other than that sacred Arunachala flame on the summit of the mountain. As he said on the Deepam day, Bhagwan particularly pointed out that we had to go around him three times and prostrate. So he is our Arunachala Jyoti, Akhanda Jyoti. He is our Paramatma Jyoti. He is the Antaryami Jyoti. And the very symbol of what we have to achieve, attain, that we must have this Atma Jyoti Darshan inside. So let us pray, let us offer our prayer at the feet of Bhagwan. At the same time, how is it possible to attain the state, to get this Atma Deepa Darshan? Bhagwan has prescribed Nama chanting for all of us. It is at once simple and profound. And he has told us not a single Nama goes waste. Sitaram Das Swami says, with the cannon of the Nama, shoot out all the deficiencies, all that is unwanted in us, so that we get cleansed to accommodate the divine in us. Sita Ramdas Swami says that the devas, the celestial gods, they drink this amrita. They churned the ocean and got a pot of the nectar. And this nectar would give them amaratvam. But then they still feel this anger, fear, sense of enmity, and desire after desire, jealousy, all the negativities of the mind. And that's why you hear about the Puranic stories, how the Devas fought with each other at times, and the Asuras. So in spite of the Amrita Kalas, in spite of the Amritam, the nectar, they have not transformed much. They do not have the contentment. They always feel they lack something. But then this Namamrita, the Amrita, the nectar of the Nama, it uproots all the negativities of the body and the mind and the prana inside, which is moving all the time, because the entire cosmos is only manifestation of this prana. The Nama has the ability, the power to make, to bring this prana to a standstill. The ever-moving prana will be brought to stillness, and that's when we get into samadhi. The Nama will take us from the prana, the ever-moving, restless prana, to prananath. This is Namamrita. So let us light the sacred flame of Nama on our tongue, so that all the darkness of inside will be dispelled, and pray always for the welfare of the entire spectrum of species. Bhagwan, we beg you again and again, because that's all we can do, for your immediate divine intervention to free not only the humanity, but the entire spectrum of the jivarasis, as they call it, the varieties of species, the varieties of beings at different levels of consciousness, living in different worlds, from the clutches of all these unwanted, virulent viruses of the body and the mind. And we beg you again and again to help and protect all those selfless people who slog day and night for the sake of the others against all challenges of life. And we beg you, we beg and pray for constant remembrance of your name. We beg you for that great blessing to light the lamp of Nama on the tongue, which would lead to the lamp of Jnana, the lamp of supreme knowledge, the knowledge of the sacred flame inside our heart, the spiritual heart. We beg you for being good instruments in your hands, so that we could run our everyday life as an offering to you. And finally, we beg for that supreme blessing, the ultimate grace for complete purification, so that we could see only your vibrant living presence everywhere, in everyone, in everything, all the time. So that we could see all happenings of life, all happenings of the world as your leelas, so that we could see the most devastating experiences of life, cruel sufferings of life, your hidden grace meant for our spiritual growth, for greater good, for greater kinship with God, and accept it with gratitude. We pray again and again for that eternal living in you द इटर्नल एंटिटी। जय योगी राम सूरत कुमार।